They say change is the only constant. With the advent of the 21st century, the focus of telecommunication changed from voice to highly profitable data-centric services such as video streaming, file transfer, online gaming, etc. In order to accommodate the tsunami of data and to accommodate the advancements, a new all-flat IP architecture consisting of radio called the Evolved UMTS Radio Access Network or EUTRAN and core called Evolved Packet Core or EPC was adopted. Hello everyone, welcome back to the world of LTE. In our previous video, we have shown how development happened on the radio side in LTE. In this video, let's try to understand the Evolved Packet Core with a real-life analogy. Let's say Ross wants to fly in an aeroplane. Is having a mere ticket enough? No, right? Once reaching the airport, Ross needs to make sure that he is at the correct airline counter because there are other airlines counter as well. Ross identifies the correct airline counter from its seal. At the check-in counter, Ross shows his ticket to the officer. In addition to that, he needs to prove that he is the actual holder of the ticket. He does so by showing his ID card. Once the authentication is done, the officer issues the boarding pass using his ticket information. From here on, Ross doesn't need to show his ticket. The boarding pass contains vital information such as seat number, class, flight number, time, etc. It is good enough to access the aeroplane and other ground services such as rest lounge access, baggage collection, etc. There are other services as well such as priority boarding, bigger better seats, fine dining, VIP lounge, etc. Based on whether Ross has a business class or an economy class ticket, the services provided will be different. Or we can say the authorization to use priority boarding, bigger better seats, fine dining, VIP lounges, etc. depends on the class. Now, once in the aeroplane, the captain is in charge of everything and the captain has flight attendants who provide services to Ross. The in-flight services again depend on the class of Ross's ticket. So we can say, in order for Ross to travel, he needs to show his personal ID for authentication of his ticket, and the class of the ticket such as business or economy determines the services that Ross can avail. Now let's compare Ross's aeroplane travel with any user with a 4G enabled handset who wants to latch to the network to use the services. The information in the SIM card will help the user to connect to the correct service provider because others are also providing similar services. Now similar to the officer at the counter, the MME will ask for identifiers from the user. Once the identifiers are provided, the MME starts the authentication of the user by using authenticating details from the home subscriber server or HSS such as X-ray, RAN and AUTN. At the end of the authentication process, the user is assigned a globally unique temporary ID or GUTI. The boarding pass is equivalent to the GUTI. From here onwards, the GUTI will be used to avail all the services. Once the authentication is done, the user needs the authorization to use the services. The PCRF has the record of the services that the user has subscribed to. Depending on this information, the services such as high or low bitrate, allocation and retention priority, QoS class indicator, etc. are enforced. This is similar to getting the info whether Ross is a business or economy traveler. Once on board, the captain or the serving gateway, also SGW, is in charge of the services, and with the help of flight attendant, that is Packet Data Network Gateway or PGW, serves the user. PGW gets the subscriber profile from PCRF and enforces the services for the user. After this, the user is able to browse the internet, make a voice call or use other services such as playing video games, etc. So in a nutshell, the function of the EPC is to first authenticate the user using the SIM card information, then based on the subscriber's profile, authorizing the subscriber to use various services such as internet browsing, voice or video call, play games, etc. And to finally enforcing and maintaining the quality of services during the usage. So, an all-flat IP core network helped in reduction in the number of network elements, which greatly reduces the investment capital and operational cost, a better flexible core network that can be well integrated with the legacy network, and a lower latency of less than 100 milliseconds by ensuring quality of services on each node of the data plane. Now this was just a simplified analogy. There are various other functionalities that the nodes of the EPC take care of, which is not covered in this video. In our upcoming videos, we will focus on the call flows. But before that, we will catch a little glimpse of 5G. Happy learning!